Everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples. Rooting section number one has its money on Jerry Stiller and Ann Mira. Rooting section number two backs Bobby Van and Elaine Joyce. And rooting section number three is betting on Dick Gauthier and Barbara Stewart as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy.
Hi, thank you. Welcome to Tattletales. Oh, we have a lively group here today, don't we? As you know, our studio audience is divided up into three sections, each one backing one of our celebrity couples up here. Every time one of our stars wins some money, it is divided among their rooting section. Now, we have three happily married couples up here, so the first thing we've done is to get them away from each other. Let's go in the back room and see how the boys are doing. Hello, fellas. Hello, how are you doing?
Hello, hi, gang.
What are you doing? Carrying on back here?
No, we didn't do anything, Bert. No,
I'm going to be watching you very carefully. We're consigning you to solitary confinement. You will not see or hear what we are doing out here, and you will say goodbye now. Goodbye, fellas.
Bye. Hope they get the right.
I think that's where they belong, right? I'm never going to let them come back. I'm going to stay out here with you lovelies. It's nice to have you. You
all look
pretty.
Jerry sit up
You're all coordinated in green and white. Isn't it pretty?
Isn't that white?
You look lovely. We'll come back with more of Tattletales and play our first round right after this message. Don't go away now. We're coming right back.
When the A's took off.
Okay. We're ready for our first round of Tattletales. I have the ladies out here with me, where they belong. And let's see how the fellas are doing back there. Gang, how you doing?
We're
here.
Good time. Yeah.
You're there. Okay, all ready to go?
Anytime you
say. Okay, now we're going to put some music on so you can't see or hear what we're doing out here. We'll get right back to you. Bye.
Goodbye.
Bye. I love the way they disappear. Whoop, they're gone.
Me too.
Okay, ladies, we're going to ask you some questions about your husbands and your lives together. When you have an answer you think your husband's going to recognize, we want you to push that button right in front of you. But you have to do it quickly because we'll only take one response. So who's ever first on the button, they get the answer, all right? Here is the first question. A kiss you especially remember.
Did I tell
Barbara?
You?
Okay, Barbara, you're first up, darling.
This kiss I remember because it was our very first kiss, and for some reason we exchanged chewing gum. Don't ask me why.
Well, maybe it was double mint or something.
Yeah, that's it.
Okay, you.
That's it.
Give us a one-word clue that's worth $100, or a two-word clue.
I gotta go with them this time. Gum.
All right. Let's bring on the fellas. Shall we do that? Fellas,
yeah,
okay, nice. We have asked the ladies a question. When
right.
you, what we want you to do is to sound that signal in front of you there. If you recognize your wife and can match her answer from this clue. Now, here's the question. The question is, a kiss you especially remember. And the clue is gum.
Okay, good.
Richard, tell us all about it.
Well, we were doing a pilot together. We had just kind of met and didn't know each other. Mickey Shaughnessy was playing her husband, and I was just one of the fellas. And on some kind of crazy instinct, I kissed her on the set. Not on the set, on the mouth. We were in the set. I'm sorry, the set. That's something
else. That's all right.
Clean
it up, Dick. We'll
and not her set, the set. So anyway, I kissed her, and when I did, she went bloop. And just shoved a little bit of gum in my mouth, so I just chewed it and walked away, and that was it.
We go for that? Yes, absolutely. That's $100. Very good, Dickie.
Oh,
that's what she said. Thank you.
Good.
Okay, fellas, we'll come back to you in a moment. Here's the next question. The same question, a kiss you remember. Annie, you're first. Yes, Annie. Tell us a story, Ann.
Well, it wasn't with Jerry. Does it have to be with Jerry?
No, but...
Well, you don't live with me. She says yes.
No, it doesn't have to be with
Jerry. Kiss, I remember.
But he has to remember it now, remember.
He'll remember.
Okay.
Because I told him about it.
Oh,
I tell him everything. Almost. The fool, what does he know? No. I love him. Hey, here's what it is, quickly. I was in a play a long time ago. You're a very young girl. I was in a play with Jack Palance, and he kissed me. I had a cold sore, and every time he kissed me hard, this is disgusting, but it bled, and it hurt, and I hated it. Cold sore.
Your clue is a two-word clue worth $50 called cold sore, do you think?
No, I don't think you'll get it. I gotta go with cold sore.
Okay, that's what she wants to go with. She wants to go with a two-word clue worth $50 called cold sore.
Yes.
Okay, let's bring on the fellas. Okay, fellas.
Yeah, it was a good one, huh?
Yeah, it is a good one. We've asked the ladies a question now. Yeah. Sound your signal if you recognize the answer and can match the story from this clue. The question is, a kiss you especially remember, and the clue is cold sore. Yes, sir. Okay, Jerry, tell us the whole story.
Well, I think it's been one cold sore. The whole life has been...
Come on.
I feel like I've been doing dead end all my life. Anne has a thing called herpes complex.
No, it's simplex, but that's not the story. Tell the story.
You know the story, Jerry?
Well, it has to do with Jack Palance.
Yes.
Annie was doing a play before I knew Annie, a play called The Silver Tassie.
Who wants to hear? It's ancient history.
But in the play, Jack Palance used to kiss Anne, and Anne very hard on the lips.
Yes.
And too hard, as we say in the business. And Anne says, please don't kiss me because...
Jerry.
What? Jerry, what happened?
She bit him.
No.
I didn't tell that part.
Gave him a cold sore.
No, wait a minute now.
You make me sound like Typhoid Mary.
All right, you've got the story. It was Jack Palance, right? Kissing her and she had a cold sore. Well, let's score that. Okay. $50 there. All right.
50 isn't fair.
At this point, Elaine and Bobby haven't scored yet, but they will, I know.
Yes, you bet.
Ann and Jerry have $50. Barbara and Dick have $100. They're in the lead. Now we're going to play what we call a tattletale quickie. Ooh, each correct answer we get up here is worth $100, right. Okay? And everybody gets to play.
Okay.
Here we go. Gentlemen, the question is for you, but don't give me the answer until I ask for it. Here's the question. Men, if yes. your teenage daughter brought her boyfriend home and wanted him to share her room, would you say, honey, it's your decision? Or would you say, absolutely not? Okay, you got the picture now? Your teenage daughter brings a boyfriend home. Mm-hmm. What would you say? Honey, it's your decision or absolutely not? Go away and think about it. We'll come right back to you. Okay, ladies, these questions are worth $100 apiece. Barbara, how do you think Dick would feel about that?
Oh, I know exactly how he'd feel. He's a terrific father, and he would say, honey, it's your decision. That's what he says to me all the time. Not about that, but I mean...
Oh, really?
No, I didn't mean...
Listen, what are you doing around 8 tonight? Okay, so you'll say, honey, it's your decision, right? All right, let's bring on Dick. Hey, Richard.
Hello, Bert.
What would you say? Would you say to your daughter if she brought home a teenage boyfriend, honey, it's your decision, or absolutely not?
No, I trust her. I'd say, honey, it's your decision.
That's what she said. $100.
Oh.
Very nice. Very nice.
I'll make up with you.
He's kissing you, Barbara.
Is he?
Yeah. You're a nice fella. Goodbye, Dick.
Goodbye.
Okay, Elaine, how about Bobby? What would he say? What do you say?
I don't know. We don't have any children. I don't know.
I don't either.
We'll project.
Oh. Projecting.
Well, what you're really doing is getting what the kind of man he is. What do you think he would feel?
Okay, my group, do you want to say absolutely not? Is that it?
All right, you
all right, if you lose, it's not my fault.
Okay, you're going to go with your rooting section says to say absolutely
He'd
not.
He'd say
huh?
absolutely not.
Okay.
Okay, I'll say
all
he'll right, say
all right, you're
going to
trust
not.
Him. Let's see what happens. Bobby? Bobby, what would you say to your daughter if she brought home a boyfriend? Would you say, it's your decision, honey, or absolutely not?
Absolutely not.
That's what they said. $100.
That's it.
Whoa.
No way.
Whoa, close.
Not my house.
You know,
I ain't got the room anyway.
It really is amazing. They know.
They
are really right.
They
okay.
know.
Okay, thank you, Bobby.
Good boy.
And how about Jerry? What's Jerry going to say? Would he say, absolutely not, or it's your decision, honey?
Well, I hope he'd say that. I mean, it would be another mouth to feed anyway, wouldn't it? I hope he'd say, absolutely not.
All right. Okay.
I don't want to support another teenager.
Let's bring on Jerry. Jerry, now you know the question. If your daughter brought home a teenage boyfriend, would you say, it's your decision, honey, or would you say, absolutely not?
Well, I'd feel very pleased that she'd want to ask me that question. I'd say it's your decision, but you'd have to take the... I'd have to take the hinges off the doors.
Now, I'm sorry. You have to take the hinges off the doors?
Take the hinges off.
I'm sorry. That's not what she said.
No, honey. I'm not playing
you. Absolutely not. Okay, that signal means it is halftime. And our score at this point is... Ann and Jerry have $50, Elaine and Bobby have $100, and Barbara and Dick are in the lead with $200. All right. Now we're going to play a little turnabout. Ladies to the rear, fellas to the front, and while we're turning around our positions here, we're going to break away and come right back with more of Tattletales in just a minute. We'll be right back.
It's the science of black and...
P.org.
Okay, we are back with more of Tattletales. As you know, our studio audience is sharing in the winnings of our celebrities up here. But let me tell you this. If your rooting section is backing the winningest couple at the end of our show today, we will add a bonus of $1,000. All right. Gentlemen, you're out here ready to go now.
Yeah, right.
Yes. You look terrific and poison,
thank
I must
you.
Tell you that.
Without those things.
Yeah, without the earphones on. Yes. Let's bring in the ladies and see how they're doing back there. Ladies.
Yes.
Are you all tuned in? Everything okay?
Yes.
Got your headphones on and everything?
Yeah. Yes.
All right, we're going to cut you off now. We'll get back to you in just a minute. Bye. I love to cut them off in the middle of a word. It's terrific.
That's great.
You mean bloop, and they're gone. Right. Okay, fellas, I'm going to ask you questions about your wives and your lives together. When you think you have an answer your wife is going to recognize, press that button right in front of you, but do it quickly. I'll only take the first response.
Okay.
Here's the first question. An incident with the police. Something you had, some run-in. Jerry. All right, Jerry. Tell us a story, Jerry.
Well, the story, well, it happened to a very famous lady today who plays Maud, Bea Arthur. Annie and Bea were in a play called Ulysses in Nighttown with Zero Mostel. And Bea said one night, this goes back some years, come home with me because Jean, her husband, Jean Sachs, was not home. We got home and her house was robbed.
Whose house was robbed?
Bea's house was robbed. We walked in right after the robbery. And she said, stick around until the police came. And we called the police. And they came, and they wouldn't leave.
The police wouldn't leave?
They wanted, because they like B and Ann, and...
sat around, had a few drinks.
And we had...
had their own series today.
Yes.
All right, now what I need from you is a one-word clue that's worth $100 or a two-word clue worth $50.
Maud.
No, now, wait a minute. Yeah. Wait a minute. We can't do that. We can't use the proper names.
We can't use...
No.
Wait, all right, wait. It's not right.
We can't use a name.
Okay, show. Show.
Show? Jeez. They say no.
We
have to have a clue.
All right, let's make it fingerprints, because the police were looking for fingerprints. Robbery.
Robbery? Okay. You want to go with robbery, Jerry?
Let's... Yes, robbery. Robbery.
All right, a one-word clue. All right, let's go.
All right, we'll go with the robbery.
Okay, let's bring in the ladies. Ladies, we have asked the fellas a question. We want you to sound that signal in front of you when you think you recognize your husband and can match his answer from this clue. Here's the question. The question is, an incident with the police. And the clue is, robbery. Robbery. Okay, Elaine, tell us about it.
I'm interested.
Well, there was a time with a robbery with the police when the lady next door, we had just taken her to dinner, and she came, we went to bed, and it was like 2 in the morning, and she came screaming and banging on the doors and saying, I've been robbed. We called the police quick, and we were running out there in our nightgowns and everything like that, and they started looking at us like we were crazy.
That's a fascinating story.
Yes. I know.
But it isn't the one we were looking for, Ann.
I'm sorry, again.
Does that sound familiar to you, Ann, at all? An incident with the police and...
At Bea Arthur's house?
Yeah. That's the one we were looking for. Too bad. Sorry about that. All right, ladies. Sit tight. We'll be right back to you. Okay, fellas.
It's a nice story, honey. Right,
next question.
Okay.
What she likes when she wakes up in the morning. All right, Bobby. Okay, Bobby, that's the question. What she likes when she wakes up in the morning, and I can't wait to hear this.
Wait a minute. Liable to finish the show right now. My wife likes the first thing. My wife in the morning eats immediately. She likes food, anything that's in the kitchen, she eats. She just likes to eat in the morning. That's our first thing she does is go right to the kitchen, and it's eating time.
Okay, so we need a one or two word clue from you for that.
Well, eat.
Eat.
Eat, I would say.
Okay.
Eat. Eat.
All right, that's I think the general clue. Consensus is a one word clue, and it's eat. All right, eat. Let's bring on the ladies, shall we? Okay, ladies, we've asked the fellas a question. Sound your signal if you recognize it, and recognize the answer from this clue. Here's the question. What she likes when she wakes up in the morning, and the clue is eat. Ooh. Who was first? It was close. Anne was first. Tell us about it, Anne.
Well, I like Jerry to bring me coffee in bed.
She likes that. Yes, she does.
I do like that.
Well,
I like
that's
a lot
nice.
Of things. I'm wrong, aren't I?
Just yeah, you're, yes, no, you're not wrong. I'm sure you like that. But Elaine, it sounds familiar to you too, doesn't
absolutely.
it?
Absolutely. I tried to get there as fast as I could. I'm sorry. I probably didn't eat enough this morning.
I'm sorry, too. We have no score there. But at this point in our game, Ann and Jerry have $50. Elaine and Bobby have $100. And Barbara and Dick are in the lead with $200. We'll come back with more of Tattletales in just a minute. Don't go away.
Oh, sure. 642. Call now.
Okay, we're back with what we call a Tattletale quickie. Each correct answer is worth $100. So, fellas, you ready? Ladies, are you ready?
Yeah.
Ladies, I'm going to ask you the question, and you think about it, and then we'll come back to you for the answer, all right? Here is the question. Would you describe your husband as handsome, interesting-looking, or cute? Handsome, interesting-looking, or cute? Think about it. We'll come right back to you. Bye. This kind of puts you on the spot, fellas. You got to kind of think.
It doesn't put me on the spot at all. I know right what to go. Now, whatever she calls me cute, I hate it. And I go, don't call me that. So she'd have to say handsome.
Okay. I think so. I think you're a swell-looking fella, too, Dick. You silly goose. All right, let's bring on Barbara. All right, it's worth $100, Barbara. How would you describe Dick? Would you say he's handsome, cute, or interesting looking?
He's my big, handsome man.
That's what it says. Okay.
And he hates that.
Good. Isn't that funny? That's what he said, too.
But he hates being called handsome.
He hates being called cute, is what he said.
Oh, is that what he said?
Yeah, he said he just can't stand to be called cute. All right, thank you, Barbara. Let's go down to Bobby. Bobby, what do you think Elaine will say?
I think I know my wife, and I would say she doesn't. Maybe she thinks I'm cute, but I really think Elaine thinks I'm handsome, and that's a nice feeling. I would say handsome, absolutely handsome.
He's going to say handsome. It's worth $100, and let's see if Elaine feels that way. Elaine, how are you, Elaine?
I'm okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How's everything?
Fine.
Things good down at the plant?
Yeah.
Okay. Elaine, how do you think of Bobby? Do you think of him as cute, handsome, or interesting looking? Tell her what you said, Bobby.
I said handsome, honey.
And that's what they said, too. That's what your rooting section said. Sorry about that, Elaine.
Okay.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
Okay, Jer.
All right.
You big, handsome devil, you.
All right. My wife thinks of me as Marcello Mastroianni. And I know this because she, in her heart, she knows I'm only being dubbed in English. And she thinks of me as handsome. I've got to say handsome.
You've got to say handsome.
Yeah, handsome.
Right?
The other words don't count.
Okay. All right, let's bring on Annie, please. Okay, Annie, how do you see Jerry? Do you see him as cute or handsome or interesting looking?
No way.
Kind of a loaded question.
I know what I see him as, but I bet he didn't say this.
What do you mean I didn't say it?
I see him as handsome.
Of course.
That's what he said.
Mamma mia, of course.
$100
is good.
Love.
Absolutely. All right, that signal means our time is up. And our grand winners today are Barbara and Dick Gauthier. All right. Barbara and Dick, you've knocked out here a $300. We add $1,000 to it for a total of $1,300 for you. We'll come back with more of Tattletales right after this message. See you in just a minute. We'll be right back.
Or call 1-800-994-4291.
Hello. Well, oh, well, here we are. We've got everybody out here with us. We've had a good game today. You've all been a lot of fun. It's been fun playing it with you. Now, Dick and Barbara did pretty well, didn't you? Oh, my gosh.
Fine.
Better than you. Better
$1,300 for your crew.
Thank you.
All right. And Elaine and Bobby have 100 for theirs. Ann and Jerry have 150. That's better than a sharp stick in the eye, isn't it?
That's right.
I'd say so. Listen, Dick, you have an album coming out, don't you, shortly?
I have a comedy album coming out March 1st called The Hexorcist.
The Hexorcist, which is a play on The Exorcist, I believe.
It's pretty wild.
That's all the time we have for today. We ask you to come back and join our studio audience, who will be sharing the secrets and the winnings of our celebrities on Tattletales. Bert Convy saying, see you next time.
This is Jack Clark speaking for Tattletales, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.